It has been 11 long years since India witnessed one of the worst terror attacks in history. The Mumbai 2611 attack was a ghastly attack carried out by the Lashkar-e-Tayyaba, which is backed by Pakistan. India has, on several occasions and at various forums, spoken about the pathetic manner in which the trial is being conducted in Pakistan. On its part, Pakistan has maintained that it has done all it could to bring terrorists to justice. However, we will present to you what Pakistan has really done, and this would help in exposing the nation and its seriousness in fighting terror. The status of the trial. In January this year, a Pakistani court suspended the trial in the 2611 case in a bid to give the prosecution more time to produce 19 witnesses. The judge observed that the witnesses were not appearing in court out of fear. The Federal Investigation Agency sought more time as it was unable to produce these witnesses. Officials in India say that it is true that the witnesses are scared to depose, but there is nothing that the administration over there has done to protect these witnesses. The sham in Pakistan. Zakir-ul-Rehman Lakhvi, the commander-in-chief of the Lashkar-e-Tayyaba, was one of the main plotters of the 2611 strike. Pakistan claims that the trial against him is on. However, he and six others have managed a virtual acquittal. In 2015, the Islamabad High Court had directed the anti-terror court to complete the trial in 2 months. It has been a good 4 years now since that directive was issued to the trial court, which began the hearing in 2009. In April 2015, Lakhvi walked out of jail after securing bail. There is not much news about Lakhvi, and intelligence agencies that MyNation spoke with say that there is a clear directive from the ISI to Lakhvi that he stays underground and let the heat on him reduce. Further, Pakistan had not for long indicated whether or not it would challenge the bail granted to Lakhvi, who is one of the most important players in the terror outfit. 4 years after the bail was granted, the FIA went up before the Islamabad High Court and sought cancellation of bail. However, there would not be much movement on this case since it was the ISI which arranged for bail bonds and surety for Lakhvi in 2015. The evidence ignored. The trial in Pakistan has been hit by delays, change of several judges, and also the murder of a prosecutor. From day one, Pakistan has been in denial mode. Despite an expose by television channel that Ajmal Kasab was a Pakistan national, Islamabad has always denied this fact. Pakistan security forces even cordoned off Kasab's entire village and made it out of bounds for the media. India has given plenty of evidence to back its claim that the attack originated from Pakistan. The casings of the explosives, the fishing trawler hijacked by the accused, the money trail, communication through voice over internet protocol, Kasab's confession, the David Headley files were all linked directly to Pakistan. In fact, Pakistan's former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif had said that the attack originated from Pakistan. In 2017, former NSA of Pakistan Mohammad Ali Durrani had said that the Mumbai attack was carried out by a Pakistan-based group. However, Pakistan has dismissed these claims while calling the terrorists as non-state actors. To sum it up, Pakistan has never been serious about the trial, and Rawalpindi would never want to bring the accused to justice. After all, these are the proxies who fight the battle against India on a daily basis, as Pakistan is well aware that it can never win a conventional war against India.